Hey guys, Jeff Lafferty, and it's Artcast number 63. I just noticed my hair is all sticking up. That's because I came straight in here as soon as I got up. Now my camera's kind of flickering. Still got the crashing problem. I actually recorded this once before, and all I got out of it was the end part of the video, so hopefully this will work. Anyway, I got big news. Remember the Dark Wolf piece that I did, that I sprayed with fixative and wrecked like 2 days ago? Or thought I wrecked. Well, anyway, a guy named Robert Jimenez messaged me, and he said that he had the same problem happen to him, and he actually sprayed gloss spray over it, and amazingly, I did the same thing, and look at that. It got completely fixed. I'm just so blown away. So thanks a lot, Robert. I really appreciate that tip. Actually, unplug something. Just my headphones. But yeah, look at that. I mean, it's hard to see in this stupid light here, but it's like you can't even. It's just completely back to the way it was. There, I mean, you can see some sheen on it now, but honestly, I like the sheen. I didn't. I should tell you the whole story. I shot this thing with this Grumbacher fixative that I had, which it was a pretty new can, and it left these white marks all over it. If you go back 2 videos, in like number 61 or 60, you can see me complaining about it. And anyway, Robert said it basically had the same thing happen. And to try, what he did was he used a gloss Krylon, I think crystal clear is what he was talking about. I didn't have any of that stuff. I looked through all my stuff, which I usually have that stuff somewhere, and I couldn't find anything. I found this stuff though, this Krylon workable fixative basically. Can you guys see that in the light? There it is. And well, it doesn't say what it is. It's not matte. It's just whatever fixative it is. The other one says matte on it. Let me see if it says gloss on here somewhere. Which I've had a couple people tell me to use the gloss or the matte Krylon spray finish or whatever. And I didn't really realize that they didn't. Just like everything, I thought it was all gloss. But I might try that at some point. But anyway, this stuff, I had some of this, and I thought, well, what the heck? I was going to wait and go get some gloss, but I thought, well, may as well just give it a try. And I just sprayed it, and right off the bat, it just kind of melted that stuff, and just it started to go away. And so then I sprayed it like 2 pretty heavy coats, pretty wet coats, and it just took all of it away. I'm just amazed that it came back to life. I just thought it was gone. And I feel kind of stupid for ranting and raving, but thank God I made that video, because if, you know, Robert wouldn't have told me that, I just, you know, this piece would be gone probably in the trash by now. And now I can, like, you know, send it to the guy who bought it, and he can give me his $50. That's awesome. And I need that, too. I mean, I really appreciate it, Robert. Yeah, I don't know what to say, but I wanted to tell everybody just in case they had that same problem. And it seemed like the wetter I got it, you know, I've always been kind of careful not to get too wet when I'm shooting spray fix. But the wetter I got it, the better actually it came out. It just seemed to kind of completely soak into whatever was on there. And I kind of, it reminded me of something I did know about when I was painting, and I didn't really think about it with this stuff, where it's kind of like, sorry, a glass of tea is kind of leaking there. But when I used to spray lacquer as a painter, sometimes when you get some kind of flaw in the finish of the lacquer, like sometimes if you were like spraying window and stuff like that, you could run into spots where the light was shining in, like sunlight. If you put, you know, spray like clear finish in sunlight, you can get some weird stuff happening there. And when that would happen, I would just, you know, give it a light sand and then respray it heavy, and the melt, the lacquer would kind of like melt into itself and it would come out completely clear and perfect again. And I guess that's sort of what happened. I mean, I didn't really think about this, but this stuff is like, it's kind of like lacquer in the sense that it's like a solvent-based stuff. But yeah, I'm just blown away that it actually worked, and I'm just super happy with it. I don't know, I recorded, like I said, this video once before, and hopefully this one will come out. The beginning of it crashed for some reason, and that's the part that I lost, which was this kind of stuff I just talked about again. So I don't know if I'll just cut it in with the end part of the other one. I'm not sure if it'll all make sense, but probably, and I'll just get this video up. Okay, so actually, it's funny, I've been having this computer freezing problem, and then my camera just froze right there, so that's weird. But my computer didn't freeze, so. But I'm back now, and I'm not quite sure where in that whole thing I kind of stopped at, but I guess I was just getting, I was just kind of ranting about the self-criticism, because I had a bout with it, you know, last night with this piece, with this darn X-Files piece, and I actually think that it's a breakthrough piece for me. You know, it's like, I feel like it's opening up, like, my style into what I'm doing, and I like that, because I've been having trouble with that. I've been having these kind of, like, thoughts about, like, I want to be an artist, like an original artist. I want to be, like, me, and I just feel like I'm just in this herd of fan art that, you know, how in the heck do I stand out in it? And I don't know. I think in some ways it's like by doing that, by doing stuff that's, now my camera's just flickering up, and I noticed the exposure or something just going crazy on it. But I think that's the way, maybe. It's just to, all the settings were right. Is to do stuff that's, you know, to let my style come through, because I don't have that same kind of, you know, style that Drew Struzan has, or, you know, or anybody really. It's like I have a style that's like mine, and you know, just really, I don't know what's going on with my camera today, but every time I look back, it's like it's doing some new, it's either super bright or going like dark, or anyway. But anyway, like what I was saying about the style is just you know, yeah, I don't have the same style as other guys, and I don't know, just try to be original in what I'm doing, and not lean too heavy towards anybody, which isn't really a problem now, but like I kind of felt that sort of with some of the movie stuff, especially with the movie stuff in color, just looking too much like Drewsters and stuff, you know. Because it's just, you know, I mean, Drew Struzan, he's awesome, and he's definitely an inspiration to me, but I have a lot of inspirations. Frazetta, Bernie Wrightson, tons of other people, and on top of that, I feel like I'm my own artist, so I want to do something that is mine, you know what I mean? And I don't, you know, it's not that I don't want to draw, you know, movie art or whatever. I love that too. It's just that I just want to draw like me. You know, I want to have like my input to that, and I think that that's the kind of thing that's gonna, you know, drive my prices up and stuff. Because it's, you know, I don't know. You can get this stuff anywhere really, but you know, if you want like a specific thing that I do, then you have to come to me. You know, so what else can I show? I guess I may as well. I got a couple more pieces sitting here. So yeah, actually, I don't have this one packaged yet. That's going to get packaged today. But this is like what I mean. I think that, you know, it's like these pieces have like my style. Sorry. I love these things, actually. I think they're cool. And they seem to be kind of like in my wheelhouse of like what I like to do, you know. Because that's the kind of art I like, you know. I like Frazetta, I like mythology, I like Conan and Robert E. Howard and Tarzan and all that kind of stuff. I also like movies. That's like what I'm trying to do, is make a living doing what I like. And then this is the piece that's on eBay. I wish my camera was doing better with the color, but this one might actually have ended by now, but hopefully it'll go for more than that $25 bid. There's like a bunch of watchers on it though, so I think it's going to go up. And as soon as I push stop on this video, I'm going to try to do kind of another little promotion run and stick it everywhere and just see if, hopefully it'll get up to, if it could get up to 100, I would be really happy. I don't know if it's going to quite do it yet. But I just got to keep doing these. I like this one a lot though. You know, it's funny, it's like I go around, I promote everywhere, and I post it on a couple boards, and there's just always people that, you know, come by and they give you their harshest critique or their, you know, and some people just don't understand what the hell they're trying to do, you know. So often you'll click in and you'll look at like their stuff and it's like, I don't know. I don't know if I go and critique people that are like, this is going to sound cocky, but like way better than me in a way, you know. It's like sometimes you go in and you see their art and it's just like so mediocre and you're like, God, you're like telling me how to fix my stuff. It's like maybe you should start doing a little drawing. That sounds terrible, but it is kind of the truth though, you know. And the other thing is, it's like, you know, you just post on those boards. I mean, I just do it just to promote. It's getting more links pointing back at my site and my auctions. And that's the truth of it, you know. I do actually like feedback from good artists, from people that I respect, but it takes a while for me to really respect someone. If someone just comes straight onto a board and starts telling me that, you know, this is wrong and that's wrong, I don't know that I listen to that at all, you know. I kind of just go, you know, maybe not, you know. A lot of what people point out is wrong, I notice, is like your style, you know. I see that with other people. They want to homogenize everything down. They go, well, everybody says that this is wrong. Everybody says that you should have your full figure, and there's, you know, if it bleeds off the page and there's no legs, then I have to come on the board and say, there's no legs on that. Where's the legs? You know? But it's like, that's just such a stupid thing. Or like, where's the background? That's another one with comics all the time. No backgrounds. And there's a lot of comics, actually, that really do that well, you know. One of them is Sin City, you know. I don't know if you can really find a lot of fault in Sin City, but very stylized, not very real looking, and a lot of panels with no backgrounds, just stark white. And also another guy who I don't think many people can argue with is Mike Mignola, you know. He does the same thing. If you look at his background, very stark. And you go, oh no, there's backgrounds in every one of those. But if you really go through and you take a look, you know, not much, you know. Anyway, I'll go ahead and end this video. I might actually cut off a little bit of that stuff. So anyway, thanks guys. Don't forget about the Artcasters weekly chat on Sunday. If you want to get in on that, head over to the Artcasters forum, and anybody can join that forum. I've had people I notice post in there, and they go, "Well, I don't know if my style fits in this forum," and stuff like that. And I want people to get that out of their head. I mean, this forum isn't for a bunch of guys doing fan art. It's for anybody doing art. You know what I mean? If you do good art, come post. You know what I mean? Because it's like everybody in there is open to like all that stuff, and also they're supportive, you know. There's none of this I don't know, closed-minded, I hate this and I hate that kind of stuff going on in this board. This board is just all about, you know, all of us making it and figuring out how to make it. That's what this whole thing is. That's what these Artcasts are about, is like figuring out how to how to make it without the gatekeepers, without going like, I have to work for Marvel, I have to work for Magic, you know what I mean? You're a freaking artist and you're doing art. Those companies don't generate art. Artists generate art. That's why we got to take it back. I don't want to get off on a rant about that, but it's true. It's really true, you know. Every one of those books is done by like a bunch of creators. That whole Magic card game is done by a ton of like super talented artists. There's no reason those guys can do their own games. It's just a construct that we put on top of the art ourselves, you know, like agents and all this other kind of stuff. Book publishers. It's all gatekeepers. Just keeping us, you know, roped into whatever, into the system. And then we all like practice and we do this and we listen to all these stupid critiques and you know, try to figure out how the heck to get by these guys, you know. Get into Spectrum and get our art on Spectrum, you know, because that's going to do something for us. Spectrum, you know, if you really boil it down to what it is, it's a book that everybody pays to get into, and a ton of people pay not to get into, you know. I mean, who knows how much money they make off the entry fees, just right off the back, that book is 100% paid for a million times over, and then on top of that, they go and sell it back to the people that want in there. I'm not saying anything bad about Spectrum or anything like that, but that's like the definition of a gatekeeper. And we all sort of like go, oh, you're in Spectrum, you know what I mean? Do something yourself. Do something on Kickstarter, you know? Make yourself like a place that, like a farm on the internet. You know what I mean? A farm that grows its own corn and feeds it to its cattle. And its goats and its chickens and makes everything itself. And then you take a little bit of what you got left over and you go sell it. And you get your salt and your sugar and all that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? And then you have something that nobody can take away. That's what I mean, I guess. I don't know. How am I getting off on these big old tangents about this kind of stuff? Anyway, I was talking about the Artcasters. I'm going to try something different. I'm going to try to I'm going to try to embed the Artcast in my website, basically, before it goes. Because I noticed there's like an embed code. So I'm going to do a blog post on like Saturday and say, hey, the Artcast is tomorrow. And embed the thing in there. So if you want to watch the show, I think you can just go to my site, and if it's going, you can watch it, and if it's already played, it should be there. So that's what I'm going to try to do. If you want to be on the show, because if you're in the Artcasters, you're welcome to try to get on the show, and there's not many people trying to get in right now, so there's a good chance that you can. Peter posts the link at the top of the page, at the Artcasters page. I'll try to put the link in this show to the... It's called the event page or something on Google Plus, and basically you just got to go there and you got to click watch, and then Peter will invite you before the show, and then you can come on if you want to. And I think he's doing it like 1 o'clock my time, which is Mountain Time, on Sunday. He kind of is moving it around, trying to get different people in. So anyway, that's that. Thanks a lot, Robert Jimenez. You're awesome, dude. You're getting props from me for a long time. Anything you want me to promote, dude, send it my way, because I'm going to hit it hard. And I'll see you guys later. Thanks for everything. Bye, guys.